People stink. Even underground, they stink. The set doesn't need another entrance. There are a dozen old ones. But the one he uses most has been blocked.
Other badgers used other exits. That one was his. To use other exits meant crawling through other tunnels.
Only a few weeks ago, when trying to use an entrance he'd passed through many times, the group's younger male, a three-year-old, bit him in the arse, drawing blood.
Since the fight, he avoided that route, staying out of the path of the younger, stronger badger. And if he went the other way, he would have to go past the angry sow protecting her cubs.
It was easier to move earth. So he digs now, a tunnel he's been working on for weeks. Every day shifting soil, depositing it outside in untidy piles beyond the other entrances.
The digging makes him hungry. He is spending too much time deep in the safe soil. Not enough outside, searching for worms and beetles.
But the darkness is reassuring. Darkness is his element, protecting him. It is the light that is dangerous.
Today, the hunger begins to rouse him early. It is hours before he dares to go outside. Two cubs are shuffling somewhere down the tunnel. They are hungry too. Fatten or die.
And then the dull noise of footsteps above jolts him fully awake. The humans are back. They are close.
He lies still in the darkness. In another chamber, he hears the old sow and her cubs moving. They have heard it too.
This is not the usual scent, though. Beneath the surface, there is an old stink of bones.
Tonight, he will dig some more, bringing old earth up to the surface. The soil here is sandy. Tunnels collapse and have to be redug. He digs deeper.
People stink, even when they are underground.